Hi guys, Dr. J here, and in this video we're going to go through a workflow where I'll show you how to do the GCP picking in your photographs in WebODM for doing photogrammetry. So here we are in WebODM, and you can see I've got the dashboard pulled up. What we're going to do is we're going to go to the GCP interface over here on the left, and this brings up the interface for picking GCP points. Now what we need to do is have a file already ready that's formatted correctly that WebODM will recognize as a GCP file. And the idea here is that this is going to be a file which has each one of our GCPs with its elevation and latitude, longitude, or UTM coordinates, whatever coordinate system we're using. And then we'll use that file to get started picking GCMs. And you can also get this drop down here with some directions on what WebODM is going to expect. So let's go ahead and click on Load Existing File. You can see that I formatted this file in a particular way. So I've got the coordinate system up at the top, and in this case I'm using latitude longitude, so it's EPSG 4326. I've got the GCP name here on the left, or the station number, and then longitude, latitude, and elevation, and this is a tab separated file. Very important to make sure that your tab formatting is correct. I'm going to go ahead and load this. And now you'll see that these GCP points come up here on the right. And if I hover over each one, you can see which number that point is, 5B, 9, 8, and I've got half a dozen GCPs here or so. The next thing I need to do is bring in some photographs. So I'm gonna go into that same directory, pick my photos, and I'm not gonna bring in all the photos right now. I'll just bring in a handful that we can use to illustrate the process. Alright, so now I've got all these photos, and some of these GCPs are going to be located in these photos. So I'm going to come here, and it will sometimes pop up with these, it'll sort of start you out with a point, and it's one particular point. I'm going to delete that one. Notice that it doesn't delete it over here, but it does delete it over here. And I'm going to go out, I see my first GCP here at the corner of this building. I can hit plus and click right there, and I want to get it exactly in the center of my GCP flag here. Now in some cases you might have GCPs that are a building, corner of a building, something like that. I'll show an example of that in just a second. But for these flags, you know, you want to make sure, basically you want to make sure that the location of your point here, which I've just deleted actually, exactly corresponds to the place where you've made the GPS measurement. So I've got a point placed there, and then I need to associate it with the correct point over here in the map. And in this case, I happen to know this is the point 5B. So I've got that one highlighted, and then I can come over here and click. You'll see the color change. And now if I hover over this point, you can see it's associated with that GCP. Now what I need to do is actually zoom out and see if there are any other GCPs. And in fact, there are. There's one here. So now I need to zoom back in, kind of scroll up to this area. This happens to be this GCP. Notice that the flag number and the ground control point number aren't necessarily the same. You should check and make sure. It's always, of course, good practice to name your flags the same as your points. In this case, that didn't happen. So what we'll do is we'll just make sure that these are the same points, which I already know, and then I'll go ahead and add a point there. And then I'll come here and click on this point. There we go. So now if I hover over that, you can see that highlights. All right, so I think that's the only GCPs that I have here. Let me just do a quick skim around. Sometimes they're a little hard to see, especially if there's shadows and things, but it looks like I've got them all. So I'm gonna go ahead and head back. Now I can go to my next photograph and do all the same thing. Case I have a photo with no GCPs at all, and that's fine if you have photos like that. You certainly will have some, so I'll just go ahead and keep on going. And actually got a couple different points that I'm going to use as GCPs in this image. I'm going to put one here at this corner, and this one is going to be my point, where is it here, my point 3, so I'll associate those. I'm going to add a point actually right here. So I don't have a known GCP point there, but I'm going to go ahead and put that one there. And then I'm going to move this one over, and that's going to be associated with that one. And then I'm also going to add a point here on the corner of this bike rack. And I'll be able to go back and measure the corner of that bike rack. And I need to, of course, add it over here as well. So the next thing that we're going to do is we've selected a bunch of GCPs and a bunch of these different photographs. We'll come up here to export file, and you can see what we've got. So now we've identified particular pixels in images. So what do we have here in this file? We have projection information at the top. This is just projection information. This is going to be UTM zone 15, so these are UTM coordinates. That's what WebODM evidently needs to have. Here's the elevation. And then we have some information on the location of the ground control points in the pixels. So in this particular photograph, the particular ground control point 5B is found at this pixel location, which is given by probably a row and a column in the image. And then we have the name of that ground control point. And then we've got some other elevation. This is our point which we didn't have GPS information for, so we don't have elevation information for that. But we've been able to assign that. What WebODM does is it actually, based on just where these points are located in the map, it will assign those a UTM coordinate and an elevation data. So this would be the new elevation, the new coordinate that we have here. Okay, so then what we can do is we can hit save. I'm going to save this, and I'm going to download that. I'll pull that up here for you in text edit. So now we have a text file which we'll use as input to WebODM. So just to show you how that works, let me come back over here. I'll come back to my dashboard, and then I'll create a new project. There we go. And then in this mapping test, we'll select images and GCPs. And here's where I'll be able to come and I'll be able to say, okay, my GCP file is here. And then I'll select all my images as well.